guys, today's session will demonstrate create and test a posting substitution in SAP S for HANA ERP system. We'll start with the group journal entries, and we will create an entry in post journal entries app. So click on the app, post journal entries. We need to enter a transaction date here. Journal entry date. Posting date is auto pickup as today's date. Company code and transaction currencies are already filled, and then we need to select a GL account for first line item. We'll enter some debit amount. Then we'll select a tax code for our debit entry. And we'll input cost center. Once we are done, then we'll go ahead to the main dashboard by clicking on SAP logo at the left corner at the top. Then we'll select the menu. And in the menu, manage substitution and validation rules. There we need to create the rule. In the previous session, we have created a validation rule, but here we'll create a substitution rule so that a particular in case of a particular condition, a functional area in our case should be automatically filled. So the substitution is used for this purpose. Whenever the precondition exists, so it will autofill the field value which we have will select here. We need to select coding block as context, and event is also the same. And substitution rule is already selected. We'll click create button. Then we need to give some name to the rule, and also some description. Both are mandatory fields. Okay, so we'll fill up the description as per our GL account number, and the precondition on which it will activate or it will function, we need to fill in also. So we'll enter here a GL account 614 and 5 times 0 is a GL account, and it should be equals to the value I've input here. So this precondition whenever occurs, so the trigger will automatically substitute the target field value. So we'll choose here functional area in the target field. And we'll assign to a constant value YB50 for the functional area field. Here is functional area field, and we'll assign it by selecting substitution type, substitute with a constant, and we'll select our value, which is YB50. More values are also available in the lookup. And we'll save the substitution rule here, and we'll exit to the activate also. activities must, otherwise it will not function. And once we have done with it, then we can also disable it. Both activate and disable functionality are available for validation rule as well as substitution rules. Then we'll go to our entry. We'll create a new entry in the journal entries group, post journal entries app. We need to enter the date here. The remaining fields are pre-filled. In the line items, we need to select a GL account against which we have already created the substitution rule. Okay, and we have selected the account here. We'll input a debit amount after selecting the account. Okay. Then the tax code we'll enter here. It's showing item is incomplete. Let's check. Call center need to be entered, so we'll input the call center. Okay. So here we can see the functional area is automatically filled. That's it. Our substitution rule is working properly. So we'll exit by clicking the SAP logo. We'll go to accounting configuration and manage substitution and validation rule app. There we'll disable the substitution rule because we have already tested it. Thank you very much for watching the videos.